Irving, Texas. Thank you so much. Joining us now is 13-year-old Jahda and her father, Jahda Bakari. Jahda, thanks so much for joining us. Let me show the video again. I just want to show you were at the pool party Friday evening. In the video, we can see you being shoved. Tell us exactly what happened.
From the beginning of the pool party and everything?
Well, yeah, sure. Why don't you tell us from the beginning of the pool party if you want?
Okay. When we first arrived there, there was like a barbecue going on in the park next to the pool. And when we, after we all arrived, got to the pool, they all let us in. They knew there was a party going on because the security guard asked me if I was there for the party. So we went in. And then a few, like, we were there for a good 15 minutes at least. And then a worker came over and asked us to see our pool cards. And he said there could only be two people per pool cards because you need those to get into the pool. Well, we had never heard that rule before because I've lived in Craig Ranch for 2 years and no one's ever abided by that rule before. So we didn't believe that that's actually how things were working. So then we kept telling him, what about the other people at the pool? Because most of the other people at the pool were Caucasian. We asked him if he asked any of them about it. So after that, he went around and asked the rest of them about their pool cards. And then he came back to us a few minutes later and told us about horse playing, that we were horse playing. Mm-hmm. And then I said, you know, you see these white girls over here horse playing as well. And then he just ignored them because they even agreed that they were horse playing, and he ignored them, just kept talking to us about it.
Right.
And then during all that was after all that was happening, there were this group of black guys, and they were like waiting at the gate to get let in, but none of us knew who they were, so we didn't like tell them to let them in or anything. So then they went to the gate and everything, and then they kept hopping the fences, and then the white parents that were complaining, they kept saying that they were with us when we clearly kept saying that we were not with them and we had nothing to do with them.
The young men the young men hopping the fence were not with you. Okay.
Yes, because I just assumed, because like I think they assumed just because like most of the party was black and those men were black too, so they assumed that they were with us, and even though we told them that they weren't. So like after the worker came back a few times, we started getting a little upset. And then also parents were complaining about the music that was being played, even though it was the curse words were blurred out. So they were complaining about it. And that's when I assumed the fight happened, because then my aunt told us that we were going to leave. So we just told her, me and my cousins told her we were just gonna stay. And then so we like right after she left, I had to go put my stuff back down at the table that I was at. And then after I sat it down, that's when the cops, like their cops started showing up.
Okay.
And that's when everyone ran out of the pool area. And then that's when the cops were yelling at people to get on the ground.
Okay, let me just bring your dad in here for 1 second, Jahda. Jahda, you blasted this particular police officer on social media. You're saying he struck your daughter and the other teen, and you say he did so for being black. Why do you say race motivated his actions? Did you hear him say something in particular?
No, I looked at it. It was obvious that there were two crowds of people on the video. And then I saw all of his directed anger was only toward one group of people. He didn't go on both sides and give them the same tirade that he gave the black side. He gave it all to the side where the black and the Latino kids were.
And Jahda, I just want to clarify this. You've been going to this pool for years. You have a pool pass.
Yes, I have a pool pass, and many of the people that were at the pool party have a pool pass and live in Craig Ranch.
So how do you interpret, why do you think the police officer acted the way he did? Were there things, obviously there was a lot that we didn't see on that videotape. Was anybody threatening him in any way? What did we miss?
There wasn't really threatening going on. There was yelling at him. There were people cursing at him just because they were angry as well, because he hopped out of his car and he was already cursing and yelling at us. So I guess they got angry and they felt the need to yell back. No one was threatening him, but they were more so yelling at him, telling him to shut up and stuff because he was doing the same to us. And then that's why mostly everyone was getting mad, because he was telling us to stop talking and all. And you can see in my video that I kept yelling freedom of speech because a lot of like the white parents, they're telling us, that called the cops on us, were telling, telling me to stop recording and to that we don't, and that we need to stop talking. So like that's why I kept yelling at, like I was yelling at him, and he was like, that's why he got, I think that's why he got even more angry, because we were yelling at him when he was doing the exact same to us in the first place.
Well, I'm so glad that nobody got more seriously hurt. It's obviously horrific to watch on video. Jahda and Jahda Bakari, thank you so much to both of you for joining me. I hope you have a much better rest of the summer.
Oh yeah, no doubt.
Thank you.